you were mine. Hello, welcome back, or welcome if you're new here. Today we're reacting to Attack on Titan Season 4, Episode 22, I think. It's either 22 or 23. Which one is it? 23. Last time we had not a lot, honestly, compared to the last couple episodes, which I'm really happy for. We finally got like a breather episode. I mean, now that I'm thinking about it, there was a lot, but it wasn't like on the scale of like the Rumbling or getting a Ymir flashback. It wasn't on the scale of that. But it still had some stuff, like we had the stuff with Gabby, and I think her name is Kaya. That was cool. I like that. Gabby was cool in the scene. She killed Niall. I don't know how I didn't realize that. Someone in the comments had to point that out, and I don't know why I didn't, but it makes sense, yeah. And it's sad. It's really sad. And Pixis died too. I hate it so much. I hate it here so much. Yeah, I think people were saying that was Armin's first confirmed kill, which I think is kind of funny, not gonna lie. What else happened? Falco was unconscious because of the whole strain that becoming a Titan shifter puts on your body. And Connie is like, I'm gonna go feed him to my mom. And I was like, cool, let's do that. And one person, nothing against the one person, obviously, but like one person in the comments is like, that came out of nowhere. Like, why would you say that? And it's like, honestly, I care way more about Connie than I do Falco. And I think that goes for most fans. But for me, it's like, I low-key don't care about Falco. I really don't. And that's probably gonna get me like dislikes and stuff, but like honestly, I don't care about him that much. I'm not even gonna lie. Like, the amount that I do care about him mostly is through other characters. Like, I like him through Reiner. I like him through, this is gonna be really bad. I like Colt more than I like Falco. I don't know why. But yeah, and I like Falco through Gabby, but I don't really like Falco on his own. Like, I really liked him throughout like decoolating basically Gabby when they first got into Paradis. That was cool. I like that part, but like as a character, like as a whole, I've never really like been like, oh yeah, I like Falco a lot, he's one of my favorite characters. No, I don't like him that much. I'm sorry, I just don't, compared to other characters. And I think it'd honestly be I feel bad for Connie, I really do. But the person did say, but if Connie does do this, then it's just furthering the cycle, basically. And it's like, yeah, I guess. But yeah. Also, Annie's back. That happened. I'm really happy about it. I'm so happy. For so many reasons. Like, back in season one, if you have watched my reactions, I loved Annie so much. I was like, oh, she's so cool. She's like, she can turn into a Titan. She's like, she was really cool. She was like legitimately really cool, and then we got nothing on her for like three whole seasons, and like, and how many years, like in real time, like, because I've sped through this for the past year, but I think it came out in 2013, I think. So like, we've kind of, I think fans have waited like around like how many years, 9 years, I think, I'm not sure. It's been a long time for actual like long time fans. And so I'm really, why is my hair doing that? So yeah, I am happy for long-term fans, but I'm ecstatic too. And we also have Hitch. I saw Hitch in the thumbnail for the video. And so I've been wondering where she has been. I have wondered that, because like the last we saw of her, she was when Zachary died, I'm pretty sure. At least that's what I remember. We might've seen her since then. But she didn't get like any focus, like not even when the Rumbling happened and like the path stuff happened. We didn't even see her. So I think that's kind of weird, but like she was all the way, she's all the way in, the Walsina, right? Where it's Zachary and stuff, where Zachary was. So I think that makes sense kind of, but like, oh yeah, because Hitch was with where Annie is in the place where Zachary died, and that's in Walsina right now. We're on the outskirts of Walmaria. So yeah, that makes sense. This has been a long intro, but I think I cut most of it out because I was stuttering. But yeah, I'm excited. Let's just get into it in 3, 2, 1. One last thing before we start. Have you guys seen that TikTok of Armin Like, I love that so much, but yeah. Back to Annie. Oh yeah, the rumbling. The Trost District. Oh yeah, because it's happening everywhere else. We get to see what's happening, yeah. Oh, there's Hitch. Yeah, so Hitch is doing relief efforts over here, yeah. Oh yeah, so they're all, yeah. Yeah. It's kind of full circle, almost. Yeah, the wall falling killed a lot of people. I'd assume it did, yeah. This is interesting. This is really good that they're showing this, too. That's another thing I've been thinking, too. It's like, sorry, I'm pausing, but like, if Eren gets rid of the entire world, cool. You can do that. But what's going to stop from other Eldians going against other Eldians? Have you thought that far? Like, but I wonder if we'll cut to Levi. Ooh, give your hearts. They're doing that again. Is she just gonna see Annie on the ground? It's just wet footprints. Annie's out. Has Annie aged? I would assume she didn't, but. And he's just gonna see Annie. I was like, please don't blue ball us like that. I thought they were gonna cut it right there. Please don't do anything to Hitch. And what side is Annie gonna be on? Oh, she's gonna take her outfit. Hitch has grown though. Have you considered that though? And I assume Annie is really weak because, yeah. Gonna put her back in the basement. But does she have the strength to fully transform? But just like her transforming, like itself would kill Hitch, I think. What is Hitch gonna do? Oh, opening. Okay, so I usually watch the opening through when I'm reacting. I just cut it out, obviously. One of my favorite parts of the opening though is actually just this part. I assume it's just everyone reacting to the rumbling, and I don't know why, but I just love like apparently with Eren's voice too. Also, yeah, because they have the bands too, so like they're reacting to the rumbling coming towards them on the island, or coming towards Marley. That's what I meant. But I love the opening so much. Sunset. I have no idea what that's referring to, but we'll see, I guess. Was Annie conscious that entire time, though? That's the question. Oh, so she was. Unfortunately, apparently. Okay. By the rumbling, yeah. I mean, look outside. Like, you should be able to see the Titans. Yeah. So Hitch is actually going with her. It's just so nice seeing Annie again. I'm not even gonna exaggerate that. Like, it's just so nice. And it's already happened, so what are you gonna do now, Annie? Yeah, and Annie, I've never really known Annie's true goal. I hope you get that. Oh, really? Oh, so she's half Marleyan. Before North Eldian blood. Okay. Oh, okay. Yeah, that makes sense now. I don't know why I didn't pick that up before. And she did, though. Yeah. It's just like, you okay there, bestie? That's fair though. That's fair though. I listened to your BS for 4 years. You can listen to me for half an hour. Oh, okay. This is all kind of making more sense now. Because we always got like her backstory like in weird flashbacks. Even though I should have been able to pick, like, put it all together based on what we got. But it all makes sense now. Is that what her goal is? So she's grown a little bit. Where are they heading, though? Yeah, you can't stop the rumbling. Information available for public disclosure. Used as a bogus threat by the 145th King Fritz to bring peace to Paradise Island for the past 100 years. Due to the Val renouncing war, the rumbling and its millions of colossal titans could not be put into motion until now. Following the collapse of Paradise Island's three walls, the march of the colossal titans flattens everything in their path. Now that the rumbling is underway, destruction of the world is not far off. Love that for us. Oh, and they're all talking to the Marlenes because the Marlenes don't know about it at all. You know what would be interesting though, if I'm pausing again, sorry. If they, because they were all able to see each other in the paths, right? So it would have been interesting if, like, Annie's dad and, like, Falco's parents saw them in the paths. That would have been really cool. Oh, yeah, this is happening too, yeah. Wait until the first Colossal Titan comes and they just leave all the Eldians in the camps. He thinks he's never gonna see Annie again, and he might. I don't know what's gonna happen, but oh, he just went crazy. Okay, good for him. I don't know. What are the Jaegerists doing now? Like, Floak, can he just stop? Like, honestly. Yeah, literally, Pixis is dead. So. But the thing is, he's still useful, though. I'm too old. I want to say, like, no, they can go against him. But, like, I don't think so. He's basically just saying infiltrate the Jaegerists, like, then, I guess. Try not to lose yourselves. I don't think you can convince Connie. Connie has death flags right now. I don't like it. I really don't like it. I'm not having a good time right now, but... What does that mean, Armin? Yeah, at least for now. So he's trying to make them all be as united as they can. Yeah, when was the last time they slept? Armin's think about the big picture. Ooh. Veronica opened the door. Armin and Cannon. Nah, you can't help Aaron right now. Armin's finally snapped. Yeah. There's too much. There's just too much. Oh yeah, where is Historia too? I didn't even think about that either. Armin, baby, sleep, please. Armin finally snapped though, and I like it. Don't say that. Maybe question mark, but now it's giving very much Armin death flags, and I don't like that either. Oh, so they're all comforting Gabby. That's nice. Is Gabby going with Armin? Kind of a cute moment, I think. Okay, but the close-up of Armin in that new scout uniform, I'm loving it, like, honestly. I hate Floak so much. Can he just stop? Like, why does no one just pull a gun on him? And I get it's, like, the general fear and stuff on Yakopon. Yeah, who elected you? Like, of course it was Eren, of course. I mean, I don't think Yelena cares about her homeland, honestly, but like, I feel bad for them, honestly. What is John gonna do? I mean, dude, I think anyone would have, like, basic pride there. Like, someone put a bullet through Floak's head, I swear to God. Is it Ms. Mikasa gonna do it? If anyone can stop Floak, it's Mikasa. He's gonna solve it inside the land. Oh, and they're helping Yelena up in the background. Yelena's not having a good time. He's using the manipulation and stuff. I do miss that John. I'm not even gonna lie though, but because like John still has a mom. Like, we've gone over that. Wouldn't you like to know? So yeah. Connie. Yeah, Connie's gonna end up hesitating. He's not a nice person. You've definitely seen him somewhere before. Definitely. Oh, post-credit. They could avoid the rumbling if they go into the things. It's Pyek. Okay, so they're still alive. That's good. Hanji! Her voice. I love her so much. Oh, that's interesting that she was, like, controlling her Titan even from, like, the neck. That's cool. There we go. So they're alive. That's good. I was kind of spoiled on that, kind of. I've been on Attack on Titan TikTok lately, if you couldn't tell. And so I have been getting some spoilers, but yeah. This is already playing, so I guess we'll just, I didn't pause it, so. Yeah, so John and Mikasa have some trauma, but they're resting, that's good. Armin and Gabby are looking for Connie, that's good. Floke, Onyankopon, Yelena. What's going on in Yelena's head right now? What is going on with Yelena right now? She just saw Zeke die. I assume Zeke's dead. I assume he is. That's a funny, that's a cute, I don't know why, but like, it's probably, I assume that's probably like, they're right in front of Connie's mom, and Connie's about to do the deed, and, but like, that's a cute thing, I don't know why. Armin comes. Okay. Next episode is called Pride, which we got a little bit of focus on with Floke, so that's probably gonna be, Pride is probably about like Connie's pride and then Floke's pride, basically, and people's pride for their homelands, which are about to be destroyed. So that's cool, I guess. Really good episode. Discussion time. People are not having a good time with this because Eren, the rumbling, the walls fell and it killed a lot of people, and I think it definitely killed Zeke too, because he was right underneath the wall too. So, I mean, maybe not, because he was right at the gate, and I don't think there was no Colossal Titans in the gates. Maybe the gate is still standing, and so maybe the rubble didn't fall on him. Maybe I'm just remembering wrong. I don't know. I need to drink water. My throat's going to give out, but yeah. Yeah, people aren't having a good time. Eren Jaeger killed his own. There's people against Eren and people for Eren, basically, and like I was thinking this the entire time. I was like, yeah, Eren can get rid of everyone that's not an Eldian. Eren can do that. Yeah, he can genocide everyone he wants. But the thing is, though, there's going to be, what's going to stop infighting? Like, just what's going to stop Eldians against Eldians, basically? Hitch. I love Hitch so much. Hitch finds Annie. Annie is really weak, but she still gets her to end up helping out. Yeah, we get a little bit more of Annie's backstory, and it's really cool because we already knew everything, basically, at least I assume, but it was kind of like we were just kind of having to, but we were kind of just having to, like, piece it all together ourselves, because we were kind of getting it in, like, weird, muddy flashbacks, so, yeah, and we also got the reveal that, yeah, she was hearing everything. I think that's kind of funny, which I assume she did, but, yeah. Also, I love how Annie's like, I listened to you talk about your boy problems for, like, 4 years. The least you could do is listen to my trauma. I love that so much. Yes, Annie didn't care about life in general, and that fits her character. It fits what we knew about her. But then after this moment, she knew there was more than that, I guess. And I want to go back and rewatch the series because it's like, what did, like, what clues do we get to how she actually is? Like, it's just, there's a lot with Annie. And yeah, I do want to read the manga. Speaking of manga, I went to Japantown yesterday, and I didn't get any Attack on Titan manga. I got some Given and Dr. Stone. I posted it on the community tab. They did have some Attack on Titan, though. I'll put it up on the screen, like right here somewhere. And they would just play anime openings, like in the store, and where the manga store I was at. And one of the openings was the rumbling, and I thought that was just kind of cool. But yeah. Yeah, so all of the Eldians in the internment zones, I think they were called, are saying, bro, like, we saw this vision of Eren coming to kill us all. Are you gonna do anything about it? And the guy's like, no, like, it could all be a thing set up by all the Eldians. And yeah, and he threatened to just, like, shoot everybody. And Annie's dad is just like, screw it, like, kind of done with it. Shadis is just saying, like, just infiltrate, we can't do anything. Don't forget who you are, though, and that's kind of nice. Armin finally loses it, and I love it so much, for a lot of reasons, just because it's not what we normally get of Armin. And it's giving very much like Veronica Open the Door Armin, which, if you haven't seen that, go look it up, it's amazing. But yeah, we're just gonna repeat the history basically. He's so tired. Yeah, basically it's just like he's just saying like everything we do right now is gonna matter forever, basically. So we need to do everything we can to fix it now. And that basically means he wants to go to get Connie to stop feeding his Falco to his mom so that we can all have peace within the Titan shifters, basically, I'm pretty sure. Which is like okay, I guess. I mean, he says we're all gonna be on this island, and I think that's true. I mean, if the Colossal Titans go and stomp down everywhere and leave like only footprints, there's not gonna be vegetation, there's not gonna be anywhere that you could like actually like live, even if like we like okay, we've used all of the island's capacity for like humanity and we're gonna go overseas and branch out, whatever. They could do that, but I don't think there'd be anything left, like any vegetation, any animals. I don't think it'd be possible. So yeah, yeah. And then Floke's not having a good time either. So Floke knew about everything from Aaron. Whatever. I know I'm supposed to hate Floke. I know I'm supposed to hate Floke, but that doesn't make me hate him any less. It's more just like the fact that like he needs to die. Like honestly, like. Can someone like? I'm surprised Nikasa hasn't just killed him yet. But I think it's probably because like, he's like, oh yeah, Aaron's put me up to this, and I'm doing all this for Aaron. All that stuff. So I don't know. John's not having a good time either. Connie with that moment. He's like, oh yeah, I was a soldier. Yeah, and Falco's like, oh thank goodness, Connie's a nice person. It's like, yeah, that's not really what's gonna happen, but yeah. They're okay. Hanji's okay. I love Hanji's voice, the way she's introduced here. Hano, like I just love her so much. Yeah. And so yeah, Levi still lied too, which is cool. I don't have any theories at all. I saw someone say like maybe Hanji, Levi, Peek, and the other guy might end up trying to stop Connie, but like Armin's already going to stop Connie, so like it's fine I think now. Yeah, I don't have any theories. Yeah, I think we're kind of, I've gotten everything I wanted, so I don't know where we're gonna go from here. So yeah, this has been fun. I'll see you guys next time, and bye.